the show about whether or not the evidence at hand, establishes whether or not the BJP is emboldening vigilantism. That's what this show is about, and that's what my question to you is about.
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. Because if BJP would have emboldened vigilantism, as you say, then there have been 13 cases. Okay. Pilibhit UP, Rampur UP, Azamgarh UP, Agra UP, Dudhali UP, Hashimpura UP, Jaunpur UP, Azamgarh UP, Meerut UP, where Muslims have actually attacked the Dalits. The media has not reported it, perhaps.
I'm talking about Gauraksha violence. I'm not talking about all violence. I'm talking about Gauraksha violence. Why is it so hard for all of you to respond to the specifics? Why do you keep deflecting to Kerala? Why do you keep deflecting to attacks on Dalits?
Because this is a trap. Because this is exactly the trap. Because this is exactly the trap against which we are protesting. You can't have a selective debate on Gauraksha, debate after debate without mentioning
Parliament has debated this yesterday.
Without mentioning,
we're not having a debate in isolation.
Yes,
Parliament has debated this yesterday. We're responding to that.
Yes.
Where is the isolation?
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm sure you would have heard. Yes, of course you would have heard Hukum Narayan Dev Yadav ji's speech also in the Parliament, where he mentioned that in the Madhubani districts, when Muslims stopped religious processions, cultural processions, despite Muslim youth being involved in it, of course it has everything to do with
that.
The
point here is that I'm not even, by the way, mentioning the affiliation of those who are actually carrying out the violence. I'm very much on point with how I started this show, that it's senior BJP leadership that through their words and actions have tacitly or openly emboldened vigilantism. That's the point. Like a minister turning up at the funeral of someone accused of killing a man on the basis of cow slaughter. Like a chief minister saying anyone who kills a cow will be hung. Like the BJP taking out ads, inserting the entire Gauraksha discourse into an election. What is this? If it's not emboldening vigilantism.
Srinivasan ji, repeating the same thing again and again, over and over, will not make the picture as clear as it ought
because
to be.
You haven't answered.
I congratulate Rakesh
because
you've
not answered any of this.
Can I please complete? Yes, I have.
No, you've not.
I have an answer to that. But will you please allow me the same? Okay, then fine, then I'll keep quiet. I mean, you're allowing everybody else to speak except me and Rakesh Sinhaji without interruptions.
Okay, go ahead. Go ahead.
When you have a motivated campaign running around without any bearing on data, when you have senior journalists coming up and using words like RSS cadre loosely, when you have another senior journalist saying that RSS does not keep a record, but we feel that that's the case, then I'm sorry if on feelings, within feelings and data, if there is no match and there is no conjunction, then I'm not ready to buy the narrative. And millions of logical youth in this country are not going to fall in this trap of ideologically motivated smear campaign.
Okay, can I just get last?
Number two, I would have easily given this smear campaign. No, I need to have some more airtime to be able to present my views.
We're out of time.
I have a specific problem when you mention Junaid, when you mention Akhlaq, but you fail to mention the names of the victims in Margarita constituency in Assam, in Hojai constituency in Assam, because they're all Hindu.
This has got nothing to do with that discussion. Can I just get an absolute last word?
This has absolutely got everything to do with vigilantism, about state-sponsored vigilantism.
We're totally out of time. Can I just get a last word from Dushyant Dave?